Hello friends, welcome to today's machine learning class. And in this class we will move to the next chapter of second unit, that is Bayesian learning, right? In this Bayesian learning, first let us see why Bayes theorem is important in machine learning. After that we will see thing about the features and drawbacks of Bayesian learning. First let us see why Bayes theorem is important in machine learning. Bayesian learning algorithm that calculate explicit probabilities for hypothesis, which is very useful for understanding many learning algorithms. And the naive Bayes classifier, which is actually the extension of Bayes theorem, which are most effective learning methods when compared to the decision tree, neural network and other machine learning algorithms. Next, let us see the importance of Bayesian analysis in artificial neural network. Here, the first one is choosing to minimize the sum of squared errors. Let us see these things in the forthcoming classes. Okay, minimize the sum of square errors when searching the space of possible neural network. This is the first one. Okay, choosing the minimum sum of square errors. Second one is deriving alternative error function and cross entropy, which are more powerful than the sum of square errors when learning the target function that predicts the probabilities. Okay, that is alternative error function and cross entropy. And third one is the Bayesian perspective to analyze the inductive bias of this decision tree learning algorithm. And this inductive bias are very much helpful for short decision trees and minimum description length principles. Okay. Next, let us see the features of Bayesian learning methods. So here the Bayesian learning provides the more flexible approach to the learning algorithm, especially for selecting the training examples of your model, because by using the training example only we can train our model, and this can be gradually increase or decrease, that will be decided by this Bayesian learning. Okay, by this way this is very important. And second one is the prior knowledge that can be combined with observed data. Here the observed data is nothing but the training data, right, to determine the final probability of hypothesis. Okay, for this the prior knowledge is important. And the Bayesian learning, the prior knowledge is provided by declaring the prior probability for each candidate hypothesis and the probability distribution over a observed data for each possible hypothesis. Okay, so the prior probability and probability distributions are provided by machine learning. That will be very important for any learning method. The third one is a Bayesian method can accommodate hypothesis that makes probabilistic predictions. That is, a patient has chance of 93% of complete recovery. Okay, otherwise a student has 85% chance of getting pass in the forthcoming university examination. Likewise, we can get the hypothesis by using the Bayesian methods. And the new instance can be classified by using the classification methods by combining the prediction of multiple hypotheses weighted by their probabilities. Okay. And the fifth one is Bayesian method provides a standard of optimal decision making. This is important. Okay, by using Bayesian method, we can get the standard of optimal decision making than other practical methods can be measured. This will give some better decision making. Now let us see the drawbacks of Bayesian methods. Okay, the most important difficulty of this Bayesian learning is it requires the initial knowledge of many probabilities. If the initial knowledge is not known in advance, and it will estimate those things by using the background knowledge, previously available data and the assumptions about the form of underlying distributions. Okay, so the initial knowledge of probability is very, very important here. The second important one is the significant computational cost which requires to determine the Bayes optimal hypothesis. Okay, that is linear in the number of candidate hypotheses. Okay, here in certain special situation this computational cost can be significantly reduced. Up to this, we have seen why Bayes' theorem is important in machine learning, features of Bayesian learning methods and drawbacks of Bayesian methods in machine learning. Okay. And in the next class, we will see the Bayes' theorem and one example for this Bayes' theorem. Thank you.